Good morning. Welcome to the public roundtable of the Committee of Finance and Revenue. Time is now a little after 10 a.m. I recognize the presence of myself and Councilmember Grassa. We have three items on the agenda today. First, PR 2734, the National Presbyterian School, Inc. Revenue Bonds Project Approval Resolution of 2014, which will authorize and provide for the issuance, sale, and delivery in an aggregate principal amount not to exceed $5 million of D.C. revenue bonds and provide for the loan of the proceeds of the bonds to assist NPS in the financing, refinancing, or reimbursing of costs associated with an authorized project pursuant to Section 490 of the D.C. Home Rule Act. The project is located at 4121 Nebraska Avenue Northwest. So welcome to the council. All righty.
Thank you. Good morning, Chairman Evans and members of the Committee on Finance and Revenue. I am Anthony Hedden, Project Manager with the D.C. Revenue Bond and Enterprise Program, a function within the Office of the Deputy Mayor for Planning and Economic Development. I will keep my comments brief as I have submitted a more detailed testimony for the official records. I appear before you today to seek your endorsement of a proposed $5 million financing of the District of Columbia Revenue Bonds on behalf of the National Presbyterian School through the District of Columbia Revenue Bond Program. The purpose of this session is to acquaint the committee with the nature and scope of the proposed financing and to permit the public to express views regarding any aspect of the proposed project. Notice of this session was published in the Washington Times, April 28, 2014. Not less than 14 days in advance of this meeting. NPS intends to add 9,400 square feet of classroom space and renovate 4,500 square feet of its space of its current facilities located at 4121 Nebraska Avenue in Ward 2. This expansion and renovation will allow NPS to deliver better services to its students and community. The Department of Small and Local Business Development and the Office of Planning are in the process of reviewing the applicant's application. The Department of Consumer and Regulatory Affairs, Department of Employment Services, Office of Tax and Revenue have all provided approval for the applicant's project. Based on the foregoing, we have determined that the proposed project complies with criteria for approval of a project under financing of the District Revenue Bond Program. This concludes my testimony. At this time, I'd like to turn this portion over to Mr. Jim Neal.
Thank you. Good morning, Council Member.
Good morning.
Good morning, members of the committee. My name is Jim Neal. I'm the head of school at National Presbyterian School. And joining me is also Sean Nguyen of Bulls Community Stores, who's serving as counsel to NPS. I'm here today in connection with NPS's request. District of Columbia approved the issuance of up to $5 million in tax-exempt revenue bonds on behalf of NPS. NPS intends to use the proceeds of the bonds to finance the renovation and expansion of our school building to provide additional academic and administrative facilities. The renovation and expansion will allow NPS to better serve its students and its community and will help ensure NPS's sustainability. NPS was founded in 1969. It began as a cooperative nursery program for 3 and 4 year old children. Kindergarten class then being added in 1972. And grades 1 through 3 were added in 1976. Curriculum and programs were further expanded to include grades 4 through 6 over the next couple of years, and we had our first sixth grade graduation in 1986. NPS currently has 305 students from nursery through sixth grade. About 58% of the students live in D.C., and 19% receive financial assistance. Over the years, NPS estimates it's educated approximately 1,300 children, the majority being residents of the District of Columbia. NPS employs over 70 persons, including seasonal, temporary, and part-time employees. Of these employees, approximately 55% are residents of the District of Columbia. We share the district's commitment to encourage small, local, and disadvantaged enterprises, and in connection with our project, we will sign a certified business enterprise utilization agreement with the Department of Small and Local Business Development. We will also execute a first source employment agreement with the district's Department of Employment Services. We respectfully request that this committee and the council support the issuance of up to $5 million in tax-exempt revenue bonds. The bonds, of course, would not constitute a debt or liability of the district and would be repaid solely by NPS. We appreciate and support the responsiveness of your staff
and the staff of the Revenue Bond Office, and we look forward to working with you and them to complete this financing. Thank you, and I would be pleased to answer any questions at this time.
Okay, thank you very much for your testimony, and I'm very familiar with your school. I have a lot of friends, parents who sent their children there, including my wife, and very pleased with what you're doing. So we'll be supportive. Let me go to Mr. Grasso.
Thank you.
Thank you. I don't have any questions.
Okay. Well, thank you for coming down to testify. What are we looking at, Ruth? Our June 3rd legislative session. So we'll mark this up next week and get it on our June session. It's a one-vote proposition, so we should be in good shape to get going.
Thank you very much.
Good. Well, thank you very much for coming down.
Have a great day.
Bye. Okay, our next issue is PR-20-749, the Lab School of Washington Revenue Bonds Project Approval Resolution of 2014. Will authorize and provide for the issuance, sale, and delivery in an aggregate principal amount of $18,235,000 and provide for the loan of the proceeds of the bonds to assist the Lab School in the financing, refinancing, and reimbursing of costs associated with an authorized project pursuant to Section 490 of the D.C. Home Rule Act. The project is located at 4759 Reservoir Road. So, welcome to the Council.
Good morning, Chairman Evans and members of the Committee of Finance and Revenue. My name is William Liggins, Director of the D.C. Revenue Bond Program. I have already submitted a lengthy and informative written testimony, and we would like to get right to the testimony of the head of the Lab School, who is Catherine Chance.
Welcome to the Council.
Good morning, Chairman.
No, I think you can actually don't make the same mistake again.
There you go.
Here we go. Okay.
Redo it?
Got it.
Yes. Good morning, Chairman Evans and members of the committee. My name is Catherine Schantz, and I'm the head of the Lab School of Washington. Our outside counsel, Mike Graff of McGuire Woods, is accompanying me today. I represent the Lab School in connection with the school's bond application. We ask that the council approve the issuance of up to $18,235,000 in tax-exempt revenue bonds on the school's behalf. The bonds would not constitute a debt or liability of the district. Founded in 1967, a day school for children with learning disabilities, the Lab School was incorporated in 1982 as an independent nonprofit educational institution that today enrolls approximately 356 students in grades 1 through 12. The school is organized as a nonprofit educational organization under Section 501(c)(3) of the Internal Revenue Code. The school is located on two campuses at 4759 Reservoir Road Northwest and 1550 Foxhall Road Northwest in the district. The school intends to utilize the bonds proceeds to, among other things, finance the construction of a new high school facility in the approximate amount of $16,685,000 and two, to refinance on favorable terms the approximately $1,210,000 of existing debt incurred to finance the school's business office located on White Haven Parkway. It is anticipated that the high school building, which will be constructed at the Reservoir Road campus, will be completed by December 2015. Roughly 22% of our students represent racial and ethnic diversity. In connection with the financing, we will continue to support small, local, and disadvantaged businesses and district residents generally in relation to our contracting and hiring opportunities in connection with the projects. Thank you very much. I have brought prepared remarks that I will forward to your staff. We are happy to answer any questions.
Okay, thank you very much for your testimony as well. Again, I'm very familiar with the Lab School. One of my daughters attended there for the summer. My wife taught there as well. So you guys do a great job. What stands out, Councilmember Grasso, is you're building a new high school for $16 million. In the District of Columbia, when we build a new high school, it usually costs us about $70 million, 110. So is this the whole high school you're building, or just like a little classroom?
Well, it doesn't include a gym or a swimming pool. We already have one of those. And yeah. it does not include art studios because that's on in a separate building. So it includes classroom space and a large common area uh-huh. space. It's 30,000 square feet. And for us, it is a substantial expansion.
No, I just marvel at the fact that private schools can build things for $16 million and the D.C. government spends, as David said, 110. Now it's probably a bigger high school, but I mean, I've never understood how we spend so much money on these schools. I'm just astonished. And yet we continue to do it, as of yesterday, you know, putting more and more money into building more and more schools. So anyway, but the lab school is a great school. We'll be supportive of this. So Councilmember Brasso.
I'll also be supportive. I think it's a good school and really important for our community. I will note that often we have to tear down old buildings and you know, prepare the land, and there's a lot that goes into some of these builds, and I think it's important to note that some of the other high schools, like for example the Duke Ellington School, you know, is a rehab which is going to cost a lot more to do than you know, ground up, which is important to note. It's still probably a government premium added to it that has to happen as well in the community to make sure people are employed in the city. So it's, you know, probably is always going to be a little bit more money than the private sector can do. But that's our job to make sure that it's not over. You know, the problem is what happened is they say it's $70 million and then they're three quarters of the way through and they come back to the council and say we need another $30 million to finish the job. And that's where oversight, I think, is imperative and where we need to put the stops on it. So what I would like to see is some of those swimming pools open. In some communities, they build beautiful new swimming pools and don't open them. So that would be nice if we could just get them open. That would be good. I'd pay a lot more money just to have them open.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'll support this. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much for coming down to testify. And it'd be the same timetable as the other one. Okay. Our last measure is PR 2750, the Two Rivers Public Charter School, Inc., Revenue Bonds Project Approval Resolution of 2014. Will authorize and provide for the issuance, sale, and delivery of an aggregate principal amount not to exceed $13 million in one or more series, and provide for the loan of the proceeds of the bonds to assist the Two Rivers Public Charter School in the financing, refinancing, or reimbursing of a cost associated with an authorized project pursuant to Section 490 of the D.C. Home Rule Act. The project is located at 1227 4th Street Northeast. And welcome to the council.
Good morning, Chairman Evans and members of the Committee of Finance and Revenue. I am Jasmine Brown, Program Analyst with the IRB Program, a function within the Office of the Deputy Mayor for Planning and Economic Development. I appear before you today to seek your endorsement of a proposed $13 million financing of the District of Columbia Revenue Bond Series issue on behalf of Two Rivers Public Charter School through the Revenue Bond Program. On record, you have my written testimony. The law firm of Ork, Harrington and Sutcliffe Bond Counsel to the Industrial Revenue Bond Program has primarily determined that the applicant is a 501c3 organization and the project constitutes a permissible undertaking under Section 490 of the District of Columbia Home Rule Act. All district agencies responsible for the review of this application has recommended approval for the applicant project. This concludes my testimony on behalf of Two Rivers Public Charter School, and at this time we will have the testimony of Jessica Wodach, Executive Director of Two Rivers Public Charter School.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Chairman Evans, Councilmember Grasso, good to see you. I'm the Executive Director at Two Rivers Public Charter School, Jessica Wodach, and I'm here today in connection with our application for up to $13 million in tax-exempt revenue bonds. The bonds would be issued by the District of Columbia on our behalf. Joining me today is our outside counsel, Eve Corbin of Aaron Fox. Two Rivers, as you hopefully know, is a preschool through eighth grade school. We serve about 516 students. We're currently located on the borders of Noma and Capitol Hill neighborhoods at 4th and Florida Northeast. We're a very successful school, Tier 1, for the past 3 years, and we serve primarily students from Wards 5, 6, and 7. We hope to replicate our very successful elementary school program by leasing another school facility located at 820 26th Street Northeast in the district. The proceeds of the bonds would be used pursuant to a plan of finance to finance, refinance, or reimburse Two Rivers for certain costs of developing the facility on 26th Street. At present, the facility is approximately 70,400 square feet. It would be used primarily as an elementary public charter school campus. The bond proceeds would also finance or refinance pre-construction services, design, engineering, furniture, fixture, and equipment associated with the facility. Proceeds would also fund certain working capital costs and other related costs. Two Rivers takes seriously its commitment to being a good corporate citizen and a member of the local community. More than 60% of our employees are district residents. All of our students live in the district, and roughly two-thirds of those students are minorities. In connection with the financing, we're signing both a certified business enterprise utilization agreement and a first source employment agreement relating to our contracting and hiring opportunities in connection with this project. I appreciate your time. I've got remarks that we'll submit for the record. As you know, I'm happy to chat about anything and would love to have you visit Two Rivers to see what your help will help us accomplish. Thanks.
Thank you very much for your testimony as well. And I'm familiar with the school, and you're doing a great job, and so we appreciate what you're doing, and we'll be supporting this measure as well. Councilmember Grasso?
Thank you.
I don't have any questions. Thank you much. I'll be supporting as well.
Thanks. Okay. Thank you for coming down to testify.
Yeah. Thank you.
All right. Is there any more business to come before the committee? Seeing none, the meeting's adjourned.